Yes, guys, so I will be talking later about my experience here. Well, you don't feel that because if you're in my shoes at the time during the typhoon, that was the most scariest I've ever experienced in my life. Like, I didn't see that coming because I did not know. Hi, so good afternoon. I'm making my tea today. Well, this would be my lunch and breakfast and dinner. / lunch, breakfast. Yeah, I have my bathtub here, so I'm just gonna... I'm gonna be cooking a vegetarian tuna egg beaches. So that would be my food today, tuna egg beaches. Yeah, so as you notice, guys, I'm using my old stove today. Of course, yeah, I bought this. This is really for my camping, and this is not good for, this is not really stable because it's need a flat surface to put the stand on there. Yeah, so that's why I said I'm gonna use my old stove. But the problem about this, there is no an ignition, you know, so when I turn it on, there's no ignition. That's why I need to buy a new one. So I need to use a lighter to have this ignite. Yeah, so now it's on. Yeah, so I just finished. So that's why maybe you're one, you know, wondering why I have, yeah, I have actually two of them for my counting and for in here in the bathroom. But then I found out that, you know, it consumes a lot. Like, you need to, you know, I have to buy them like another boutine is, yeah, because this, you know, not much inside here, just maybe five. I can use this 5 times. You know, it depends, like, or let's say a week. So I'm using it a week for my cooking here, heating my water. Yeah, so today I'm gonna be cooking my veggies, tuna veggies, tuna egg veggies. And have my big mug, so that's for the coffee, but this one is just for my tea. And I'm gonna be using my, yeah, I still have the cauliflower, but then I decided to just put it my cabbage as well, you know, to have more. I guess I'm gonna finish my cauliflower because it's been there. I need to buy some more. So I usually put it inside here, my cabbage and the so that it will just last longer. You know, if you just put it in the refrigerator or to the it turns out that it has more life, like still gonna be fresh until maybe especially the cabbage, maybe 2 weeks. Yeah, you can stay in the refrigerator for 2 weeks if you put it inside a sellable bag. So I just threw that in the, yeah, so as you can see, this is my cabbage here. Yeah, and this time I'm gonna put a tuna. I guess I'm gonna cook a lot today for dinner. Yeah, so I'm not gonna cook any more dinner, so to save my routine. Okay, I'm gonna have to put this on. Just use this like this. Okay, I'm gonna wash it. This is how I do for washing this. Yes, guys, so I will be talking later about my experience here. Well, you don't feel that because if you're in my shoes at the time during the typhoon, that was the most scariest I've ever experienced in my life. Like, I didn't see that coming because I did not know. Maybe you wonder what is in there. Will I have a bathtub? So that's really that is good. Okay, I guess it is good enough. So set that aside. I will make an egg. Yeah, I guess this time I'm gonna use maybe 4 eggs this time because I want it to be until dinner. I'm gonna cook this. So that's where I'm gonna eat for my dinner. So maybe 4 eggs this time. Yeah, so this time I'm using my table because it turns out to be, you know, much higher. 3 eggs I think, because I'm gonna save some for tomorrow. So I'm just gonna put it in here. So this is where all of my garbage there. Okay, I'm gonna drink my tea first. Yeah, my experience during typhoon, guys, was very scary, like frightened. Like I never so scared in my life before until this typhoon came. And aside from scary, it's very, like, you know, for without too much electricity here, so that's even more worse without the electricity, because half of my roof, at least half of my roof, came off. They've been like destroyed everywhere. Yeah, so actually, guys, I don't use any, like, maybe what is it, onions or garlic. It's just good, you know, go directly. Like, I don't use none of them because, I don't know, maybe it's not available, you know. I don't want to get used to having them when I'm cooking. Because how about if it's not available, or now it's getting expensive, you know. So I just try to educate myself, or to, you know, that if it's not there, it's not there. So it really doesn't matter if, yeah, that's why I need to use a lighter with this, unlike the other one. So unlike the other one, is automatic ignition. So this one I have to use a lighter. So that makes me why not to buy for my camping. Well, that's for my camping anyway, but I need to use them as well. Okay, so I'm gonna be cooking my tuna, egg, and veggies. So that would be tuna, egg, veggies, all right? So I'm gonna put a little, yeah, this time I don't wanna use butter because it seems like the butter is only good for egg, but then if you cook something like this, you need to have more. So it would not be like sticking on the frying pan. Yeah, so guys, for 2 months that I don't have the electricity, and I was worried, scared. I'm hiding here in my bathroom because after the typhoon, it was just like 3 days of sunny days. And then after that, it's all rainy season, like so scary, rainy and windy. It's not really just like rain. It's also very windy. So I guess I need to use this because I don't have no more strength. Like, and aside from that, guys, so you know what I'm scared about? Because every time it rains, it's just gonna go inside my house, like to the second floor. So that's why I said, oh boy, that's how I start my, I was so depressed and scared and lonely. So you name it, everything. So I was feeling like vulnerable. I cannot do anything because I have no electricity. So that's how I started, like, how, what I'm gonna do, you know, if it's raining. So I'm just gonna use, I think, half of this because I don't wanna, like... So just have half of that. And then... I'm gonna... put my veggies here, and then it so that it will be cooked, you know, before my the egg. Nervous, scared, and no electricity. So what you gonna do if you're in my shoes? Stop. Very tough situation. So that's why I decided that I was praying hard to God that, you know, that I could find a worker here to work temporarily. When I went to the store, the construction supply or whatever, there's they run out of everything, like no galvanized, no nothing, you know, because every, you know, as soon as the I just stay in my bathroom, as soon as the typhoons, you know, I did not even go to the upstairs yet because I'm scared to look what it is in there, because I know there was, it's chaotic. I know that because I hear that the night before, even if I'm here, I hear them, you know, the big wind, something like there's something like, eh, you know, the sound of the wind, and I think the tree is falling apart. My roof, I hear them. So that's why I said to myself, you know, the day after the typhoon, I don't want to go up there because I know I'm not ready, I'm not prepared yet to. I'm not prepared yet, the real thing. So then here you go. I went to the maybe 3 days after. Yeah, because it was sunlight. So I tried to find, like, since that there was no more galvanized, so I thought I can just buy a tarpaulin. But oh boy, you have no idea, the tarpaulin is very expensive. 2,500. And if per meter you're gonna buy, like, instead before I you know, I bought some you know, just regular tap, it cost like 50 pesos, and then during the typhoon it became like 150 pesos, so it's 3 times the price. So that's why I said, okay, since I could not find it, could not find a galvanized this time, so I can use a tarpaulin just to, you know, to cover up my broken roof, my ruined roof. Okay, now I'm gonna put my egg here because I think this is so good, guys. I've been doing this like forever. This is really my favorite, you know, breakfast, lunch. So this is really I like. Okay, now I'm gonna Okay, guys, so when I went to the store, I bought the tarpaulin. You know, I hired somebody here to, you know, to install them. And here's the wind came, and here's the rain, and you know, my neighbor says that my tarpaulin looks like a flag. They were just flying everywhere. And I said, yeah, it's not gonna do any good. I mean, it's not working, my tarpaulin, and it's ripping off. You know, so then the water start coming inside my second floor. So what I did, I put lots of bucket and rain, you know, basin, water bucket in there. So just, you know, it's not gonna go directly to my floor, to my second floor. Yeah, but then it start leaking inside. The leak is just going everywhere in my, you know, to the ceiling. So I have a ruined ceiling, I have a ruined roof, and everything's ruined here. And so I said, okay, it's not gonna work. The tarp, it's not going to work. So I thought, well, I guess I'm gonna have to find a galvanized, temporary galvanized, to just install the galvanized, because the tarpaulin's not working. So luckily, when I went to the store, I mean, they have the supply now. Like, yeah, the day after, I just really don't care anymore. Cause, and then what the problem is, I have the galvanized, and then all of the, it's a metal frame, like C4 lens and some angle bar. So it need electricity. And at that time, we have no electricity. And I keep praying hard to God that, Lord, send people here to, you know, to have something to work in the my house. Yeah, and finally, there was a guy that he owns a generator. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna put a little bit of paper in this because, you know, I a little taste since I have I found this. Yeah, so I don't put any salt, so just to have a taste, because the what do you call this, the tuna's already been have a flavor, right? Like, it's not like what do you call this, tasteless. Yeah, so then the people, they have a, you know, that they own an a generator. So that's how I felt relieved. And guys, you can't believe that I spent like maybe everything to put the roof, but yeah, maybe 75,000 pesos plus the material, the labor cost. And that's 75,000 pesos. And the people says in my neighborhood, well, you can build a little nipa hut on it. You know, with that price, I said, yeah, what can I say? So that's another really trouble for me. So while I'm doing the cooking here, yeah, while I'm doing it, guys, I have something in here. Like, I need to fix this. This is my extension wire. Yeah, and I cannot use it because, no, you know, I did not know that it's already like this. So I don't know if I want this or I'm just gonna, I need a little this one as well. I need to make a new one for this. You know, as if you can see, guys, yeah. Because I have my mixer there for my, you know, music, whatever. So I need also a little, and this is too long. This is like 5 meters. So I guess I'm just gonna make a little, I'm just gonna take this off. This thing right here, take it and replace it into a little, yeah, while I'm cooking. Yeah, I have my thing over here. I still have this. Yeah, so I'm just gonna make a new extension wire while I'm doing my cooking. Well, I'm gonna move. So this is the good thing about this, because I can just move it, you know, or whatever. Standby, I'm not gonna stay in here. Yeah. So I turn the fire low. So I'm gonna make a quick fix here. Yeah, when things like that, guys, bestie, whatever happens to you, you have to be like, you know, prepare your soul, your mind and soul, because you don't know what's coming. And I did not know until that time, until I went to the church. Yeah, I used to go to church like around 12 o'clock, and then the first thing that the priest said, that you have to prepare yourselves now, because we have a big typhoon coming. And I said, what? And said, yeah. So when I get home, I turn on the I listen, and yeah, it's really coming, and I don't know what to do now anymore, because I don't know what to expect. So I prepare everything, you know, like whatever that I can just hide it. But eventually, I was just like, I take this off, guys, and as you can see here, I have my outlet. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna strip this skin. Yeah, you will learn a hard, you know, you will learn, I learned a hard ways. Like, it's not really easy to, yeah, so now I can relate that all the people that are, you know, having hit by a typhoon, like especially in Leyte, and that's really terrible. And you have no idea that the nervousness, your feelings, it's indescribable. And then, yeah, then when the typhoon hits here, I have actually two Atlas Tower windows broken. My door was broken, and I was like almost blown away. I'm inside my house, but the wind, really, when I try to close the door, going to you know, because I have my sliding door, like a glass door, and that's where when it's broken, I try to close my dining door so that the wind cannot come in. So that's how I, you know, the wind really blows me. Like if there is no cabinet there, I was just like, you know, something like, yeah, I guess this is ready. Yeah, I don't want to overcook this. I'm gonna taste it. It's good. I can taste the you know, I put the pepper. I need to turn my fan on. I'm getting hotter here. Okay, guys, I think I'm gonna do this. I'm not gonna Yeah, typhoon is really scary, guys, and aside from scary, it's became expensive. When I spent like 75, and until now I could not fix my roof, and I still don't have my roof, and I'm just gonna wait for the right time, for the right people to work in it, because I don't want, you know, the thing about me, I don't want other people to come in here, especially if I don't know them. And then at that time, I thought that I need a slab, you know, another slab there. But this house is not prepared for a third floor, you know, so it's very scary to have a slab. And then how about now, I changed my mind, how about this earthquake? So that's another thing, since this house is not prepared for the third floor. And then actually, God really sent people here to work for just a flat roof. You know, it's a galvanized, but then it's just underneath, you have a firewall there, so it's just underneath, so if there's the typhoon came again, it's not gonna blow my roof anymore. So then I turned him down because I thought, you know, I want a slab. So, and after all, because I know that guy and he's a good guy, you know, he's been doing lots of houses, building lots of houses na already, and he's just my neighbor's friend. So when he left, we did not see him anymore. So that's why I said, well, I guess it will take a while until I'm going to have my roof. Because right now I cannot stay by the sala, or you know, because that's all of it's just so messy there. So messy, and aside from that, it's the what do you call this? Mosquito. Yeah, guys. So that's where my loneliness take over. I was so depressed and lonely. And because I don't know what's going on, have no idea, you know. And then when you're lonely, everything's like turned into depression, like. So I try to cope up that, because it's not forever that I'm gonna be lonely. I don't want that feeling. It's ridiculous. Yeah, and it needs like they said it needs like maybe big money and the labor cost for the roof. So I thought, yeah, I'm gonna wait. Because anyway, I have a safer place here. You know, it's not like I'm having a hard time. I'm so happy here so far right now. Yeah, I guess I'm recovering from the depression and from the loneliness. So I cannot feel that way forever. I need to, what do they say, that move on and start all over again. Yeah, I cannot just like torn. I guess I'm getting ready for this. Because I cannot wait na, guys. I'm gonna be like eating. Yeah, I don't have a thing to take off this. You know, like I need to do it with this cutter. Yes, guys, you saw. I've been here living in my bathroom for how many weeks now? Months? How many months or weeks? But this would be my permanent room here. Because aside from I feel safe, I am happy, and I feel much more of you know, serenity, something like that. Like, I don't want to be depressed anymore. I don't want to be lonely anymore. Those times were so over. So I wanna start all over again, and you know, things will be good for in the future for me. Yeah, and I have my kamuti for this food. So my kamuti, kamuti is like a, what is that in English? Potato, yes, I have a potato. So I cooked my potato earlier. You know, last night, it was last night. That was really my leftover potatoes. Yeah, so luckily, guys, I have my, you know, my neighbors. My neighbor support. My neighbors loves me. I love them. They're just like my family to me. I need to finish this because I'm going to eat. I need to finish this first. Yeah, I guess we're good. So actually, guys, when you have the depression and then loneliness first, depression, you just have to have another outlet, you know, like you cannot focus on that thing just because you're happy, you're unhappy, you're lonely. Try to reverse it. Like, that's what I did. I try not to think too much of those unhappy, you know, moments occur in my life. So I try not to do that much, not to think about that. Because if I keep thinking about it, then it will just gonna ruin me. It feels like, you know, you cannot do nothing about it if you're turning back. You can't. There's no really way that you can stay with that position. You have to move on. You have to let go whatever unhappiness you've been feeling, because that's gonna, you know, that will, I would say, killing you. That's why there's a lot of people having like what do you call that, like suicide. They gonna have to be a suicidal. I made a mistakes with this because there's a hole in there, so I need to put the hole first before. Yeah, so you cannot just, you know, thinking about those bad things happening. Well, there's a lot of good things ahead of you, so much more. What is it, yung makabuluhan? Much more worth living. Like family, friends, you know, relatives. So, and always talk somebody, you know, when I had my, you know, I always talk to my friends when I was so lonely before. I have my very good friend that she just wants to listen to me, whatever. Like, you know, I said, oh, I feel so bad. And she's just there. So, okay, you can just, you know, we're both like feeling each other's problem. And that's the good thing, having friends, because they can really relate. If they're really, you know, good friends of yours, so they will always listen and they will always give you an advice, so whatever that they can, you know. So I owe it to them, because you know your family is far away, so you cannot, they're busy as well, so they're not really so unlike when you have your friends, you have your neighbors, and then you can just talk to them, and you know, you can tell them, you know, what's going on in your life. So that's really big. Yes. If you have a problem, if you feel that you're having such a terrible life, if you're feeling that way, yeah, so that's how you're gonna really talk to them, because they're always there for you, especially your family, your friends, your relatives. You cannot rely other people than your family and your friends. Because the people who, you know, when you talk to somebody and they don't know you, they just don't care about, you know, what you're talking about. So it's not really important to them. But when you feel that they really are your friends. Okay, guys, I'm done in here. I guess I'm gonna just be cooking, eating. So before doing that, okay, I'm gonna... It's really working because I'm getting hotter in here. I need to have the fan in front of me. Here you go, guys. So here it is. So this would be my outlet in here, and I'm gonna try it right now if it's working. Because if it's not, then it's not gonna. Oh, yeah. Now it's working, guys. So I'm gonna eat now. because I'm feeling so hot, 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 hot. So I'm gonna get my potato. So where's my potato? So I'm gonna save one later. So that's all for today, guys, and I'm gonna update you next time. Thank you so much for being there. I love you, and bye bye. Talk to you soon.